when you start learning astrology, you will see that most of the times there are two houses which are ignored. First is the second house and then is the fourth house. So I will be making videos on the fourth house and some other houses specifically which are ignored, and especially the third house also later. But today's video is on the second house. So somebody asked me a question that, can you share some secrets about the second house, which we generally do not find in social media, in YouTube or other forums. So to my extent, second house, to my knowledge, it's very important. It's very, very, very important. Of course, every house is important. But today I will tell why second house is very important and what everybody misses about the second house. All right. So if you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then you could subscribe down. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your horoscope, any area of your life, or if you want to know more about your second house and its contributions to your life, then please go down to the description section. You will find my website there. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will be there. So now, what's the second house? Second house, they say, is the house of wealth. Not physical wealth, also physical wealth, but accumulated wealth. And in Sanskrit, as they say, sanchit dhan. And it's also the house of sanskar. Sanskar, you can loosely interpret it in English by saying that it contains all the memories of what you think is good and bad. So the second house is very important because it defines the definition of success in a chart. So many a times you will see that there are planets in certain houses in somebody's charts, but the person is not inclined towards those areas in the way the planets speak. So for example, suppose somebody has great benefits like Jupiter, Mercury, Moon or Venus in the 10th house. So you will see that sometimes these people may not be too much inclined about name, fame, status or career. But why that is? Or you may see that sometimes there are malefics like Saturn and Rahu in the 10th house, which could give them some struggles in getting name and fame, but still they are very much aggressive towards it. Why does that happen? So to answer such queries, we have to see what the second house is in the chart. What the second house is telling, the planet in the second house is going to tell you what the person values about being successful. So for example, suppose somebody has the seventh lord in the second house, or any planet like the fifth lord, at times the 11th lord also. So suppose you have planets like the seventh lord, then it can happen that you value relationships very much. If the fifth lord is there, you might value children very much, or especially your first child. If the ninth lord is there, you could value your guru very much, or your father. And depending on the planet and depending on a nakshatra, depending on aspects and other conjunctions, it will change the game. And the second lord's placement will tell where you go to find value. That's your default instinct, that if you want to find value in life, you go to that house. Second lord is placed somewhere. So now suppose somebody has great benefits in the 10th house, or the lord of the ascendant, or somebody has planets like Sun, Mars, or you know, Mercury, Venus, Jupiter, these kind of planets in the 10th house, for example. Then, now suppose in the second house of that person has the 5th lord which is placed. So now you see, the 5th house, although it's a great house, but it is the 8th house from the 10th house. And that is why 5th house deals with promotions, but at times it deals with a loss of job also, if it is connected to the 8th and the 12th houses very badly. So now suppose the 5th lord is in the 2nd house and the person has a great 10th house. Then the person comes to you and the person is asking about family or children. And you are wondering, but he's running the dasha of the planet, which is there in the 10th house. Why in the universe is he asking me questions about the 5th house? Now, the dasha will change the course of activities within a person's life. It cannot override the chart. So, if the 5th lord is in the 2nd, then it could happen that there is a permanent imprint in the person's memory that yes, having children is very important. So that means if now somebody comes to you with his chart and you see that 5th lord or 7th lord is in the 2nd house, then you must tell him that for you it is recommended that you get married and then you have children. So these are some things which you could say. And suppose the 11th lord is in the 2nd, then that person values money very much. 10th lord in the 2nd values name, fame very much. So this is another example. So suppose somebody has the 10th lord in the 2nd house, then that person will value name, fame, reputation very much. And then suppose you have planets like Mercury or Jupiter, Venus in the 7th house, and he has Mars or Saturn, Rahu, Ketu in the 10th house. So now what's happening is the 7th house has benefic influence and the 10th house has malefic influence. So who decides who will win the game? The 2nd house decides. The ascendant decides along with the 2nd house. So if you are in conflict regarding a horoscope that what this person will do in which area of life, then you check regarding those areas, is the 2nd lord or the 2nd house associated with. So for example, suppose you are confused, this person should take up teaching job or something like that. So then you check if the 2nd house is lorded by Jupiter, Mercury, or if Jupiter, Mercury are sitting in the 2nd house, or if the 5th lord or the 9th lord or the 4th lord is sitting in the 2nd, or the 2nd lord is in 4th, 5th or 9th, because these are houses of education, teaching and giving knowledge, taking knowledge also. So that will tell you that the person is inherently interested in teaching and learning. Now the 10th house may not be linked with Jupiter, Mercury. Of course, if Jupiter is in the 2nd, from there it will throw the 5th aspect, the 9th aspect, and then it aspects the 10th house from the 2nd. So this is how you resolve some of the contradictions which you find in charts. So now suppose you find a good 7th house and you find a good 6th house in somebody's chart, and then you see the 10th house and the 11th house, they are reasonably good. So in that case, what will you suggest the person? This is one of the most frequently asked questions, that should I do job or should I do business? Well, before checking the 6th house or the 7th house, check how the person, what the person values. Is the 2nd and the 6th house linked? If they are in a parivartan, or their lords are mutually aspecting each other, or their lords are conjunct anywhere in the horoscope, or the 2nd and the 7th are linked. So now suppose if the 2nd and the 7th are linked, but the 7th and the 10th houses, they are not linked, then what could happen is the person could value partnerships very much, but he may not be interested in taking that to a level of a career full time. That could be there. So now suppose the 6th house and the 10th house are linked. So then the person may have an inclination to do job under somebody. But suppose the 2nd and the 7th are linked, then it's like saying the person wants to do business with somebody but ends up doing a job under somebody. So this is how you know where which conjunction is important, which placement is important. The 2nd house is very important. So whenever you see contradicting placements or confusions, always check the 2nd house. Alright, so that is what I wanted to say. If you are new, then like this video if you liked it, and if you like this, then share it also with somebody who is interested about the 2nd house. And if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation, then please go down to my website in the description section. Okay, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will help you find the 2nd house. Bye bye.